Place first opened way back in 1957. We are inside legendary Lambeau Field here in Green Bay. No team means more to a city than the Packers to Green Bay. And this was the scene a few moments ago as the green and gold made their way out of the historic tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the Denver Broncos. Now the young man who was a Pro Bowler as an undrafted rookie, it's Philip Lindsay. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of five. Josh Jackson, the former Iowa Hawkeye, made the play defensively.
Well, we talked about Philip Lindsay so much last year, but it bears repeating. Undrafted in 2018, the Broncos would sign him in May, and that was a good decision. He would have a 1,000-yard season, 9 touchdowns en route to a Pro Bowl appearance. So from undrafted to playing in the Pro Bowl in 10 months, that's pretty clean living for Philip Lindsay. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It'll be a loss of 1, and that'll bring up a 2nd and 11.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Pretty good running there, 9 yards. Sets up a 3rd and 1.
I thought that was a good call. Passing situation on 2nd down, they hit him with the draw instead and pick up nice yardage.
Yeah, because the draw, they're thinking pass when they see that initially defensively, right?
But you know, in today's NFL, most of the time on 2nd and long, when it's a passing situation, pass rushers are on the field and they're only thinking one thing: get to the quarterback. And oftentimes you can bypass them with a running play.
And he's going to have a 1st down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. And that gain of 9 buys them a new set of downs. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Looked like he had a couple of different options as far as who to throw to on that play. And who am I to say this, but I'm not sure he made the right decision.
Well, the window of opportunity is always going to be small in the NFL. That's why those quarterbacks who make quick decisions and have quick releases have the most success in this league.
The dump-off gets him 9, so now they're in much better shape for 3rd down. It's been a 7-play opening drive, and this is 3rd and short. Setting up to throw, Flacco. Rush coming, and he's taken down. They could not contain Kenny Clark as he gets home for the sack.
Whenever you see a team deciding to throw the ball on 3rd and 1, as a defensive player, my mindset is we've got them now, and that's why they dialed up the blitz and got after them.
But occasionally, you want to pass it on 3rd and 1. I mean, not a lot for sure, but sometimes just to keep the defense guessing.
Oh, no doubt. You want to break tendencies as you go along with the game, because you don't want them to just say, oh, 3rd and 1, we know exactly what they're going to do. But in this situation, as an offensive lineman, as a running back, I'd want to know why I didn't get the football.
The football going to Green Bay here in just a second. And the Packers, well, they made a big move at wide receiver this offseason, bringing in a 4-time 1,000-yard receiver. But sadly for the Packer fans, it was just a 1-day contract for Jordy Nelson, who wanted to retire a Packer. And why wouldn't he? Spent 10 years in the green and gold, better than 7,800 receiving yards, 5th most in franchise history.
I was looking at my boards to find that receiver.
Yeah, who is that?
Who was that that they brought in? How did I miss that news? But you're exactly right. Jordy Nelson, fan favorite, a quarterback favorite for Aaron Rodgers. And he had a nice final season in Oakland. Didn't go gently into the good night. 63 catches, a little over 700 yards. So still productive all the way through his career.
throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Here's Rodgers. Going to throw again. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 16 yards, a first down.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Rodgers now on first down. His throw caught at about the 5. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. That's a jet sweep. This is Adams. And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
Second and goal from the 6 this time. They'll go with their leading rusher from a season ago. This is Aaron Jones. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of 1 there. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. No score after 1 on EA Sports. Back for the second quarter in Green Bay. It's the Packers in possession of the football as they'll see what they can do on third and goal. And let's see 6 defensive backs out there. They're in the dime here on third and goal. Working from the gun, Rodgers. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Tell you what, Brandon, if I see a dime look, if I see 6 defensive backs near the goal line, I'm changing to a running play every time.
And they had 6 there. Surprised he didn't audible at the line?
Very much so. I'm going to count on my offensive line in this situation against the lighter defensive backs and try and push it across the end zone that way.
And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through. And the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. So still no touchdowns in the first half, but we do have some action on the scoreboard with the field goal.
So maybe now the mentality changes in this game, because anytime you can get to the red zone and if you don't come away with 6 points, you feel like it's a disappointment. In a game like this one, being able to kick field goals means you're right there and then you're just looking for that big break to take you over the top.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. This is taken at the 3. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Well, we got a moment here on the possession change. You know, it was a tough offseason for the Broncos organization. Their longtime owner, Pat Bowlen, passed away back on June the 19th, a little more than a month away from his induction into the Pro Football Hall of Fame.
Yeah, and remember John Elway, who played for the Broncos during the time Pat Bowlen took over the team and won the Super Bowls with him as the owner. He spoke eloquently of him and actually lovingly. And remember that Super Bowl, the first one that the Broncos won there with Elway? What did Pat Bowlen say at the ceremony when they gave him the Lombardi Trophy? This one's for John. So you can tell that their relationship was pretty darn special. So, you know, it's unfortunate, the loss of Pat Bowlen, but he'll be long remembered in the NFL and, of course, in Denver.
And after they won Super Bowl 50, didn't John Elway say something back to Pat?
He certainly did. He grabbed the trophy there because, remember, John Elway now is running the team and said, this one's for Pat. Pretty good symmetry there.
Throwing again on second down. Flacco, and that's complete to the tight end, Heuerman. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
They get just two out of it there, and it's second down.
I know you felt that one. Hey, we got that, Grenade.
From the 40 now on second down, Flacco. He'll find Sutton on the right side, complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. That one good for 26 and a first down. From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Watch left, watch left, watch left. He's done with him, he's done right there.
Flacco. Looking left sideline, incomplete. Emmanuel Sanders, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. On second down, a run with Lindsey. And an alley to run. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Philip Lindsay, 34 yards. And the Broncos have taken the lead. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
Yeah, that was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. McManus's point after is good, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now trotting out there, the Packers getting ready to go. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
It's Kareem Jackson making the play defensively.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who could do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. On second and nine, Rodgers. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
He sets to a 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. It's Chris Harris with a pick. And he will take this all the way down to the 38-yard line. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Here's Flacco. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Sanders. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Just like that, a pickup of 20 on their first play from scrimmage. First and 10 here for Flacco. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but if they make them out of bounds, that does you no good.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Flacco. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
So now third and 10. They had the big play to start the drive, but two incompletions since. Under pressure, and Flacco's going to be dropped. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. This from 42 yards out. The kick by McManus is good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So he gets a shot at atoning for the earlier miss here in the first half and able to knock it through.
And what a relief for him, don't you think? Because how many games have we done where kickers missed one early and never gotten a chance to atone for it the rest of the game? That's a lot to carry around.
After splitting the uprights, McManus to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. Just a lone field goal for them so far, trailing 10-3 as they come up first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw, and that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. Well, Charles, while we have a moment, you know what we need to do here is give a nod to the new Hall of Famers who were brought into Canton and inducted on August the 3rd. Champ Bailey, Pat Bowlen, Gil Brandt, Tony Gonzalez, Ty Law, Kevin Mawai, Ed Reed, and Johnny Robinson, all part of the class.
Fantastic class. When you talk about guys who played at a top level, obviously. obviously, they're Hall of Famers. But what I found interesting about it is you've got a great pass catcher, the best pass-catching tight end in history in Tony Gonzalez. How would he like to work against this secondary? Champ Bailey and Ty Law at corner, Ed Reed and Johnny Robinson at safety. Good luck trying to get open against those four. What a matchup that would have been. But it was a terrific night for those gentlemen. Congratulations. And, of course, Ed Reed's bust will go down in history because they got the hair exactly right. And Ed had a ball up there in his Hall of Fame speech.
And remember, next year they're going to celebrate the centennial year of the NFL with a special class of 20. So get ready for those speeches.
I wonder if they'll do it like Johnny Robinson this year, who actually submitted a video instead of going up to the podium. And his speech was about 5 minutes long, which is probably about the right length.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Rodgers to throw once more. And the Broncos get there and take him down. Von Miller gets him for a loss of 5. He is so tough to handle on the blitz, and that's Exhibit A.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye. That happened fast and a big sack. Rodgers in control as he hurries his guys to the line. And he's going to go down again. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. Rodgers now after the sack. He'll lead the pack up on third and long. Not wanting to risk another sack, they'll play it safe with a run. And they'll indeed stop him on third down. And now what do you want to do with your timeouts? Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. On fourth down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. River Craycraft deep for Denver.
Here we go.
The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complimentary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance. If they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
And they'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7.
Oh, yeah.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach. Appreciate it. A 1-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. This will be taken in at the 1. Then he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line.
Let's go.
And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. Again, it's Jones. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher third down looming.
I saw Von Miller in college at Texas A&M, and all I kept hearing about was his speed off the edge to the quarterback. But what impressed me his balance, and his ability to take on blocks and be a force in the run game, as we just saw there.
Rodgers going to try and throw on third down. It's caught, Jones. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Got what they needed there. The drive continues with a 9-yard pickup. Now a first down carry. It's Williams. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
The last run got six, now second and four. Back to the ground, this time with Jones. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more.
I think what we just saw there, partner, was linebacking speed that can trump O-line power. We see that at times because he filled the gap before the offensive lineman could get to the next level and take him on.
Check back 47. I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you.
From the gun on third down, Rodgers. And that is incomplete.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off.
Here's J.K. Scott now as he'll kick it away for the second time. So now a look at the Broncos as they head back out there for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah,
defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see what the offense gets done.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. On first and 10, it's Lindsey. On the tackle that time, Dean Lowry. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Now it's Flacco. Sanders has it over the middle. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
The Packers bringing in an extra member of the secondary here to try for the third down stop. Operating out of the gun, Flacco. And Sutton hauls it in over the middle. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. It'll be a pickup of four, good enough to earn him yet another first down.
And that one was a lot of fun right there, because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion, got the job done for a first down.
They look to throw on first and 10 with Flacco. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
Well, Charles, if you think so far the early part of the preseason, who has stood out? If you take a peek back at the draft, the first round, it was pretty defensively minded, but there were three quarterbacks taken, Kyler Murray first, Daniel Jones sixth, Dwayne Haskins 15th. Of those guys, they've looked pretty good.
I agree with you, Brandon. When you talk about those three quarterbacks, and you're right, the rest of the draft, we're talking about big linemen, right? We're talking about defensive players, not a lot of skilled players in the first round. But let's take the quarterbacks very quickly. Kyler Murray, by acclamation, went to Arizona, everyone excited about it, and I think his team remains excited about his prospects. They're eager to see him play. He became the starter as soon as he was drafted. Daniel Jones, that was a different situation in New York. The fans weren't real excited about him coming in, but the reason they drafted him has a similar demeanor and talent to Eli Manning, and he's acquitting himself quite nicely in the early going. And Dwayne Haskins a little more up and down in Washington, but they love the big arm of this guy, and he's back at home. Remember, he grew up in Potomac, Maryland.
The Broncos send out their punter now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. The Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Now a first down carry by Jones. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and it'll be second and 11. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Aaron Rodgers, 3 fourth quarter comebacks last year. That's the most he's had in one season in his entire career. And he's going to need another one right now. On second and 11 now. Rodgers, and he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
It is hard in zone coverage to stop a curl route, because when they see it, they just try and find the open spot and sit down.
Yeah, we always talk about finding the soft spot in the zone. What's the key to doing that? How do you do it?
You have to read what the coverage is. Is it two deep? Is it three deep? Because then you know where the linebackers are going to drop, what spots in the field they naturally get to, and you find that open space, and then you're in sync with your quarterback. He should be reading the exact same thing, and they put the ball right on you.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing again. Rodgers. Oh, no, he lost the football.
On plays like this, where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Looking deep for Adams. And that'll be incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty. And it's fourth down. A fourth and very long coming up. You're out of field goal range. I don't know that you can go for this.
Well, I know that you want to, right? You know that they want to say, hey, let's go for this. We've got the perfect play drawn up. Let's do it. But I wouldn't go for it either. I agree with you totally. You're only down one score. Punt it. Let your defense pick you up.
And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. And Denver getting set to take the field. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
Moving backwards on first down, never a good thing. What does that do for the mindset on second down?
Well, it changes your play call, definitely, because as a play call, you're advancing yourself thinking, okay, we're going to get a gain here. Now you've got to go back in reverse, come up with something to pick up not just the yardage lost, but gain a few extra.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. Blake Martinez, the linebacker, was there in coverage to disrupt. How about the defensive effort from both of these teams that we've seen in this game?
Would you say it's like a high-stakes chess match right now?
Chess is one way to go. Yeah, I like it.
Okay, the only reason I say that, you feel like they're contemplating their moves before actually making one, and none of them being done very confidently.
Truth be told, I've never played chess, and I know that I'm not smart enough to play chess. Guys like you with your IQ, you can pull that off. The Broncos send out their punter now as he's on here to punt it away. Returnable here for Davis. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. Now, if you're a fan of punting, and I know that not many people are, but this game kind of turning into one for you.
Well, it's okay if it's a skills contest, right? We're really into it then, but not during the course of an actual game. This has turned into a field position game, though. Sometimes a better punter may actually determine the outcome.
Now, the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
It's easy to see when we review this that the ball needs to come out quicker, because if you don't throw it right on the break, you bring a crowd of people into the equation.
And that's why it got knocked away there. So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Rodgers now to throw again. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. It's Chris Harris with a pick. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. Scoring has really been at a premium, and Charles, you got to tip your cap to this defense coming in here. Their offense too, but this whole team coming in here on the road, getting a hard-fought win.
I think the way that they're finishing this one up, an exclamation point on a terrific game. As you noted, hard for them to put points on the board, and they hold them down one more time and finalize things.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. And the play clock is going to run out here. They're in no hurry to get a playoff. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves them back five. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of game. Bootleg, Flacco. Blitz coming and down he goes. Preston Smith comes in for the sack.
Now we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. On third down, here's Lindsey. And he'll only get this to about the 35. Well short of the line to gain. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. So on now is Brandon McManus. He has hit from as far away as 57, but that was in Denver. This to make it a two-score game. And his kick is good. Oh, he just did tuck it into the bottom of that left corner. And they will stretch their lead to 10 now at 13-3. So his second field goal of the game, and that could turn out to be the big one.
Yeah, you have to make them score twice to beat you, and that's not impossible. But here in the fourth quarter, puts their backs clearly against the wall.
After splitting the uprights, McManus to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So Aaron Rodgers and his offense down by 10, 1:46 to go. It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance.
McManus, 258.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And left side here, it's Graham. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
Yeah, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Looking to throw again on second down. Rodgers, and he'll be brought down right around the 37. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Well, last drive he threw the pick, but he's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know there isn't a quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw 5 and still find a way to win the game in the end.
Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance.
And this is caught down for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
Extra point up and good by Crosby. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. So still a chance with just over 20 seconds to go, but they need to get this one back, no doubt. And the Broncos are able to recover, and that should just about wrap this one up. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. To Anigo's Flacco, and that should be it.
I don't know about you, partner, but watching them take the knee there and finish this one off, I feel like I'm going to be sore tomorrow. This was one bruising affair. Low scoring, but my kind of football.
Not a work of art, but maybe in your world, a little bit of a work of art. You like the defensive side.
I thought it was pretty. I can't help myself. I thought it was pretty.
And it ends in a kneel down as the clock rolls down to zeros. So this one will wind up a Denver victory. And this one won't be remembered for many offensive fireworks, but they did enough to get the job done.
And that's why it's a team game, because sometimes you have to lean on one part of your team. And they leaned on their defense. In fact, they probably went over there and asked for some help. Like, guys, we just don't have it in this one. Can you hook us up? And they did in a big way. Said, no problem. Put it on our shoulders. We'll carry you home. And they did exactly that.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hardworking men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. With that, we say so long, everyone, from Lambeau.